Initially, our work started by comparing the Homo naledi teeth to every other fossil hominin to see if the anatomy matched other fossil species, and the answer was no. And so the teeth, along with the rest of the skeleton, really gave us a hint that this was something previously unknown. Rising Star Cave is northwest of Johannesburg in what is called the Cradle of Humankind, and so it took a specialized team of spelunkers to actually reach the fossil-bearing chamber. Last summer of 2014, I and a group of international researchers began working on the anatomy of the fossils, trying to determine if these fossils were representative of species already known or if they were an undiscovered or previously unrecognized species. We brought in 12 people over the summer to Johannesburg, South Africa, to work with the Homo naledi dental remains. For Homo naledi, we have more than 200 teeth now in the assemblage that we can work with. The University of Arkansas has a long history of focusing on biological anthropology as a research. And so our research here uses teeth as a clue to social behavior, looking at clues to diet or the mechanics of chewing and things like that. So we really have one of the largest groups of people studying human origins, especially with focus on the heads and the teeth. Teeth, I think, do tell us a fairly comprehensive story about an extinct species.
You know, I have a lifetime's worth of questions that I could ask from these teeth, and the truth is I can't do it all. And so, you know, that's why we keep expanding our research team.
And so it's an amazing opportunity to really, you know, start the conversation rolling. And, you know, this is a conversation that will continue for centuries, I hope.